Hello students, welcome to today's maths class. I am your maths teacher Deepika Dubey. Today we will do second part of chapter Cards and Wheels. In today's class, we will learn how to use a compass and make a circle of given radius. We will also study about relation between diameter and radius. So let's begin. Targeted learning outcomes of today's class are to understand about compass and its parts, to be able to draw circle of given radius using compass, to understand the relation between radius and diameter, to solve problems based on circle and its components. Competency focused are knowledge, understanding basic concepts, and problem solving ability. Children, let's know about our compass. The joint which keeps two arms of compass together is called hinge. The pointed arm is called compass needle. Second arm has a grip for holding pencil and is called pencil hold. We fix our pencil in the pencil hold such that the pencil and the needle align with each other. Now our compass is ready to use. Now let's learn the technique to use compass. Step 1. Place the pencil hold in such a way that it aligns with compass needle and tighten it. Step 2. Pull both arms apart. Step 3. Keep the pointed arm firmly on paper and hold compass from tip. Step 4. Move the pencil arm clockwise, keeping pointed arm fixed at a point. Doing on my own. Now let's make a circle using compass. Look the video. The circle will be made in the exactly same way as we have discussed in technique. Wow, we have made a beautiful red circle. The point made by the needle is the center of the circle. Now let's see some tools we need to draw a circle. We need a compass with pencil, an eraser, a scale, paper, and pencil for drawing line. So let's begin making a circle. Now let's draw a circle. Now we will draw a circle of radius 6 cm and also mark its center and radius. Children, see the video. We will open our compass and place it on the scale such that middle portion lies on 0 marking and the pencil tip goes to the marking of 6 cm. Now we will firmly place the compass on paper holding from the top as shown. Now rotate your compass clockwise to draw a circle. Yes, you have drawn a perfect circle. The point where needle was placed is center of the circle. Let's name it O. Now draw a line from the center O to a point on the circle. Write the measurement of radius on the line. Now we have a circle with radius. The radius of the circle is 6 cm. If the radius is 6 cm, then what will be its diameter? Now let's see this question in next segment of this video. Let us study relation between diameter and radius. Children, look at the circle. In this circle, OP is one radius of the circle and OQ is other radius of the circle. Plural of radius of the circle is radii. Thus, OP and OQ are radii of the circles. In previous class, we have done that a line segment touching the circle at two points and passing through the center is called diameter. Thus, PQ is diameter of circle. We can also see from the figure that PQ is also equal to OP plus OQ. Since OQ and OP are equal in length, we can also write PQ is equal to 2 times OP or 2 times OQ. So we have an equation here. Diameter is 2 times of radius, or radius is half of diameter. Let's understand it more clearly. If radius OP is 3 cm, then the length of the radius OQ will be 3 cm. If OP and OQ are 3 cm each, thus diameter PQ will be 2 times of 3, that is 2 into 3, 6 cm. Yay, it's activity time. In previous class, you have drawn circles of different sizes and created different figures out of it. In today's class, you have to take colorful circles of different sizes and arrange them to create beautiful creatures, figures, etc. as shown in the sample pictures. You have to create at least 5 things like this, and you have to give them a name each. Now let's quickly revise what we have done in today's class, because it is wise to revise. We have learnt about different parts of compass like hinge, compass needle, pencil hold, etc. We have learnt that we place compass needle in the center and hold it firmly and rotate the compass pencil arm in clockwise direction, creating a beautiful circle with specific radius and a center. We have also learned that diameter is 2 times radius, or radius is half of diameter. Now we come to assessment section of today's class. Children, do these questions in your maths copies. Question 1. Draw a circle of radius A 3 cm, B 5 cm, C 7.5 cm. Question number 2. Find out the radius of the given circle if its diameter is A 10 cm. B 32 cm. Question number 3. Draw a circle having diameter AB is equal to 9 cm. I hope you enjoyed today's class. Thank you.